And we're gonna do in and outs. And there are several different ways to attack this. And I'm gonna show you all at the same time. Number one, he can go down into his push-up. And now he's slowly gonna extend one arm out above his shoulder. Above your shoulder, beautiful. Pull it back. Then he can send the other arm out above his shoulder, pull it back, finish his push-up. That's one way to do it. Now when he's extending, he's not snapping it. He's slowly feeling position, pause, lock, coming on down. He is not hyperextending his shoulder. He is keeping it underneath his shoulder girdle. The other way is starting from the top. One wrist is going to turn forward. The other arm is going to come down to the push-up. It's going to stay straight as he moves. Down, pause, pull out, and the other way. It's going to go down, turn the wrist on top, up, and finish that position. Okay, so there's two ways to attack this. One works better for others. But the main one is, if he starts with the straight arm, watch that elbow. As it comes in the second hand, the hand will turn parallel, the elbow will come into the side, midline is being stabilized. So let's show that one more time from the top. Yep. Going down, watching his arm, pulling back in. Good, take a break. Now when he's moving, when he's pushing his arm up, he's not pushing it all the way to the side, he's pushing it within his cubit, within his shoulder range. Because this is the strength that we want to develop. Cool? We're going to do one last movement before we start working on muscle-up development and being on top of the rings in support. And that's just doing what we just did, but both arms straight. It's very similar to the ab wheel, or the ab roller. He's going to start, both arms will be perfectly straight. The only problem is, I've seen too many athletes with the ab wheel, they bend their arms. We're not looking for that. You guys know that by now. He's going to start, spotting, go down, both hands on top, pause, one, two, three, pull it back. Cool, now do that again. Go down, one, two, three, pull it back. That's what we're looking for. If you need to shorten this range of motion, just go halfway, Kevin. Pause, then pull out of that. As you load yourself up, walk back down. Do you know what the cool thing about this movement is? It's going to help you with your kipping pull-ups. Watch how he moves. Watch how his shoulder moves. Just go halfway. Is he not in a closed position right now? Now pull it out. Cool, take a break, Kevin. So he's strengthening his closing position. And he's also strengthening, pushing out of there and opening up, hitting his position. So if your kipping pull-ups need assistance, this could be your accessory movement for that. How cool is that? And you get to be stronger on rings. I think it's a win-win.